scalar is any measurable quantity that can be completely described by a single piece of information, magnitude. Vector. A vector is a measurable quantity that can be completely described by two pieces of information, magnitude and direction. Velocity. Velocity is the rate of change in an object's position. Acceleration is the rate of change in an object's velocity. Force. Force is any interaction that changes the motion of an object. Inertia. Inertia is the tendency of an object to resist change in motion. Newton's first law of motion states that an object at rest stays at rest and an object in motion stays in motion unless acted upon by an external force. Newton's second law of motion states that force equals mass times acceleration. Newton's third law of motion states that for every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. Gravity. Gravity is the force that causes all objects to fall towards the center of the Earth at 9.81 meters per second squared. Conservation of matter. The conservation of matter states that matter can neither be created nor destroyed, but only transformed from one kind to another. Conservation of energies. Conservation of energy states that energy can neither be created nor destroyed, but only transformed from one kind to another. The first law of thermodynamics states that matter and energy can neither be created nor destroyed, but only transformed from one kind to another. Work. Work occurs when an object force causes an object to move in the direction of that force. Power. Power is the rate of work done per unit time. Six classical simple machines are lever, wheel and axle, pulley, inclined plane, wedge, screw. Together these form the basis of all mechanized systems. Units to measure electricity. The units to measure electricity are amperes for current, volts for voltage, ohms for resistance, and watts for power. Atoms. Atoms are the basic building blocks of all matter. At the center of each atom is a nucleus, which contains a few smaller subatomic particles. Protons. Protons are subatomic particles that reside in the nucleus of an atom.
Protons determines the kind of atom.
Neutrons.
Protons carry a single positive charge.
Neutrons. Neutrons are subatomic particles that reside in the nucleus of an atom. Neutrons have the same mass as protons but not carry an electrical charge. Electrons. Electrons are subatomic particles that reside in orbital shells surrounding the nucleus of an atom.
The mass of an electron is negligible, but it carries a single negative charge.
The atomic number. The atomic number is the number of protons which determines its place in the periodic table.
The mass number.
The mass number is the number of protons and neutrons in the nucleus of an atom. The electron shell. The electron shell
is the atoms.
Mackenzie.
The electron shell is the shell where electrons of a specific energy level can be found.
The valence shell. Valence shell is an outermost shell. Valence electrons
or shape
form. What's that, Mackenzie? Start us off again.
Valence electrons.
Look how say it with her. Yeah.
Valence. It is electrons are the electrons in the valence shell. These electrons can be gained, lost, or shared to form chemical bonds.
Valence electrons determine
the chemical properties of an atom.
Good.
Ionic bond results when valence electrons are transferred between atoms. Covalent bond results when valence electrons are shared between atoms.
All right, everybody cheer. Go woohoo!